This morning, we are learning more about the events in Boston that led police to the suspects in the marathon attack. We sat down with a 26-year-old Chinese entrepreneur who was carjacked by the Tsarnaev brothers. He goes by the nickname Danny. And in order to protect his privacy, he asked us to conceal his face and to modify his voice as he told us about that fateful night.
It's Thursday night. It's three nights after the bombing. It's about 11 o'clock.
Yes.
And you're sitting in your car. And what happened?
I saw someone, you know, pulled over to the curb just behind me, and there was a person on the passenger seat. He jumped out of the car and walked to my car. He looks at my window, so I lowered down a little bit. Suddenly, he put his hand in and opened the door from inside.
What did he say to you?
He took out his gun and pointed to me and said, "Where's the cash?"
Can you show me how close he put the gun to you?
It's right there, yeah.
So right at your head,
yeah, right at my head, yeah.
Did in any way you think at that moment, this is the guy the FBI is looking for?
No, I think it's a different guy from the picture.
He asked you a question, didn't he? Have you been following the news of the bombings?
I said, yes, of course I know. Then he said, I did that, and I just killed a policeman in Cambridge.
Now you take off driving, you had to be scared to death.
Yeah, I was
very scared. How did you even manage to drive?
At first, I kind of managed to drive. I was shaking. My body was shaking. Tamara told me, relax, man, and slow down. Don't drive too fast.
Danny followed Tamerlan's directions and drove as younger brother Jahar followed in a sedan. Tamerlan soon took over behind the wheel, and Jahar joined them in the Mercedes.
When Jahar got in the car, did he say anything to you?
He didn't say too much to me. He was pretty quiet.
Did you get a sense from the way they interacted with each other that they were equals?
I think Jahar is like a follower.
Why do you say that?
Because Jahar, he went out to the ATM. He went out to get the gas. Tamerlan never get out of the car.
So he was the guy doing the errands.
Yeah, yeah.
They loaded some things from that second car into your SUV, didn't they?
They did.
What did they put in the car?
I actually had no idea at that time.
You know now.
It's the explosives.
And when you think back that you were driving around in that car, not only with two people who have allegedly committed murder, but in the back of the car there are explosives, what do you think now?
I think I was really lucky. God was with me.
Danny considered many different ways to escape, but he decided to make his move when they stopped at this gas station in Cambridge.
At that time of night, they only took cash.
Only took cash. Jahar went inside of the store to pay cash. So I thought it was a very good chance because only one of them is in the car.
If you're going to escape, it had to be quick.
Yeah.
What did you have to do?
I was thinking unfastening my seatbelt and open the door.
With your left hand, you undid the seatbelt. With the right hand, you opened that door, and you took off.
I took off.
Did you hear him react to you opening that door?
He's trying to grab me. I can feel it. He was trying to grab me.
He tried to get with his hand. He tried to grab your back.
Yeah.
But just missed you.
Just missed me. It was very close. I can feel it.
Danny ran into a different gas station and called 911. He told police they could track the suspects through his car's satellite system and the iPhone he had left behind.
Have you thought about the fact that because that happened and they did track them quickly, that perhaps you prevented further bloodshed that night?
I was trying to do, you know, what I can do.
It couldn't have been too long after that. Just about a half hour later, there was a shootout in Watertown.
Yeah.
And Tamerlan was killed.
Yeah.
And what was your reaction?
I was still worried they will come back to me. But when I heard that news, I feel a little bit of relief.
We're going to have more of our conversation with Danny a little later in the show, including a section where he talks about getting a text message and then a phone call from his roommate. And Tamerlan looked basically at him and said, "You do anything stupid with that text message or the phone call, and I will kill you." It's a harrowing ordeal.
I can't imagine how he's adjusting. How did he seem to you? he must be incredibly shaken to this day.
Well, even now that he knows that, you know, that they're both, one is dead and one's in custody, as you can see, he didn't want his identity revealed. He has said he will testify in the trial gladly, and he knows he'll be identified at that time. But for now, he wants to stay under the radar.
We'll look for more of that interview in the next half hour.